Hello YouTubers, how's it going? Thanks for tuning in. And today I am de-rusting the lower suspension parts, the lower suspension arm on the Rover. I am using citric acid. Let me just show you. And the reason why I'm using citric acid is because it's the same stuff as Deox-C, and whereas Deox-C is about 20 pounds per kilogram of the product, this was £7.95 from Amazon. So, as far as I can tell, basically what you have to do is you mix it in some warm water, let it dissolve. It should be as clear as water, and then you put it in a suitable container. Obviously cover the parts you're going to de-rust, and obviously this is the arm here. I've got a urethane bush set to put on, so I'm going to have to remove these bushes at some point, but I just want to see how good it is, or citric acid is, at de-rusting. Okay, so let's see the result of using the citric acid de-ruster. Obviously what you have to do, when I open the garage, they still essentially look the same as yesterday, and the water was fairly clear, but they had a brownish tint to it. So I've scrubbed them with a wire brush. That's quite a soft grade wire brush. You could also use an old washing up brush, dish brush. Yes, I'm not too bad. I'm quite happy with the results. Bearing in mind it's now 10 o'clock in the morning the next day. I put them in at 3:30 yesterday afternoon, and they've just been sitting in this tray. The springs for the exhaust, these are the exhaust back box clamp springs. There's still some rust on there. Okay, so this was the system I used. As you can see on the diagram, it's very easy to follow. You can use a 12 volt battery, or you can actually use a battery charger, an old school battery charger. Not a smart charger, it won't work. This is just close up of what my system is. It's 500 milliamps. And right, so these are the big items. I wanted to try the brake disc. It's been standing around. It's not actually worn, it's just surface rust. So I used soft iron wire from a garden centre and wrapped it around all the parts. And then, as you can see, this is just a normal builder's bucket. It's got the bicarbonate of soda inside it. That's the sacrificial anode, and that's just a piece of mild steel, just a bit of scrap metal. You can use rebar, anything really, as long as it's ferrous. And just make sure the sacrificial anode and the actual parts do not touch. So I probably need a bigger bucket, but just make sure they don't touch. So yeah, just hook that over. That's the beauty of a bucket, is it's already it's got a handle, you can sort of hook things over it. I had a couple of crocodile clips in stock. They're not very big. I could do with some larger crocodile clips. There we go. Let's put that. That's the sacrificial. You can see bubbles start to form. I moved the bucket around a bit, so if you're wondering why the wires look like they're in a different position, this was this was later on in the day. And you can see the colour of the water has changed, purely because it's dissolving. The rust and any embedded grime is falling off the parts. So this is the caliper mounting bracket. And it's got some black oxide on it, but after I scrubbed it, I gave it a quick scrub with the steel brush, and it's come up extremely well, so very pleased with that. Just got to do a bit more to this bracket, and then I'm going to put you on time lapse of this. I don't know how out there so it doesn't touch. Yeah, so I'm going to do some time lapse. And so obviously the negative wire goes on the part you want to de-rust, and the positive goes to the sacrificial piece of steel or iron. I just use a piece of flat bar. And the solution is good old water and bicarbonate soda, because water isn't a particularly good conductor of electricity, but if you add bicarbonate soda or baking powder or even vitamin C from washing soda, it improves the conductivity. But don't use salt, because it's effectively you're electrolyzing water, and if you put salt in it, you'll split the salt, which is sodium chloride, and it will give off chlorine gas, which is not only bad to breathe in, but it will attack surfaces of the metal that you want to protect. So bicarbonate of soda. In fact, let me just show you, just to prove it. I used this. It is literally cheap as chips, cheap as bicarb. I used a whole one of these in the bucket to do the larger parts, and a few teaspoons dissolved in this. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put this in there just to see it bubbling. I'm going to put you on time lapse. Okay, let's see what the results are. I've already switched off the power. And let's just undo that. This is the sacrificial anode. And this is the component that's being de-rusted. And those deposits will scrape off very easily with not much effort.